Hey everybody, I'm here at the Kitsap Humane Society with my very special friend Parsnip. She was one of 250 bunnies rescued last week as part of the Humane Society's biggest rescue ever. And we've got five stories for you this week happening around Kitsap County. Stick around.
Welcome back to the Beat Blast, sponsored by the Admiral Theater. Story number one this week, Kitsap Humane Society is hopping with new guests after an estimated 250 bunnies were found in a home in Paulsbo last week. Homeowners had tried to start a rescue operation for rabbits, but quickly became overwhelmed by their rabid breeding. Humane Society staff have been scrambling to find enough space and supplies to care for their new tenants.
We are not equipped, obviously, to house rabbits on this magnitude, and we don't typically carry a massive amount of rabbit supplies, so we've had to purchase crates, food, bedding, so many water bottles, just all the things to meet their basic daily needs, and you know that's a big expense for us, and it's taking away from money we usually spend on other animals, so donating of course is super helpful, but the best way people can help in addition to that is we need to get them out of here into loving homes, whether those are foster homes temporarily until we have more space for them to come back for adoption, or adoptive homes.
Story number two today, Peninsula Community Health is taking its medical care on the road. The group is debuting a 38-foot mobile clinic that will travel to homeless shelters and food banks throughout the county to reach those who can't make it to a permanent location. The clinic features two exam rooms and a lab and can handle nearly all of the same services as their permanent locations.
We have individuals that have some severe disabilities. This improves the community relations that we have with Peninsula Community Health. And the individuals with the severe disabilities, it's a convenience issue. So those individuals have a hard time making it two blocks up the street to community health. So this will give them the benefit to come right to the back of our building and receive services from Peninsula. Hopefully this changes the health and well-being of our overnight shelter. We have a lot of sicknesses that go through here. Once one person gets it, the entire shelter gets it, and then it passes on through the entire homeless community. So hopefully this will benefit everybody involved.
Because they're focusing not just on the physical care of the patients, but on building relationships so that people feel comfortable seeking them out. I'm just really impressed with that. So like their plan is at lunch to head up to the Salvation Army and have lunch with the people that they'll be serving. So, impressive.
Story number three today. Peninsula Community Health is also looking to expand its medical care to students in schools. The success of a clinic in North Mason schools has Kitsap educators considering clinics in their own districts.
Peninsula Community Health Services opened a clinic in September on North Mason School District's secondary campus. The clinic provides comprehensive medical and behavioral health services to students and staff, regardless of their ability to pay.
Kids don't come to school necessarily ready for learning these days, and there's so many things that happen that interfere with that. Things are happening that are impacting your mental health or your physical health, and so we needed to be able to find partnerships to help us serve the whole child, because we have discovered and we know that our kids can't do their best at school if these other needs aren't being met first. We were very excited to be able to develop a partnership with Peninsula Community Health. Our goal is to open a separate location. Getting the building ready turned out to be a little bit more difficult than we had planned, so we went ahead with the partnership anyway, and Peninsula Community Health is serving students in our middle school and high school 2 days a week. North Mason is a rural district, so there's not a lot of access to public transportation, so we felt that it was important to have an opportunity for our kids to get served here on campus.
Story number four this week, if you're anything like me, by the time you get to the end of the week, you're sick of eating ramen and grilled cheese sandwiches. A new cooking class this week from Kitsap Community Resources is trying to teach adults how to buy and cook healthy meals on a budget. Finally, What's on Tap for your weekend, sponsored by Silver City Brewery Tap Room. This weekend, check out some amazing handcrafted sculptures at the 33rd Annual Kitsap Woodcarvers Show. Local artists will be showing off their work, and attendees can learn carving tips and tricks at a variety of instructional sessions. Best of all, it's free. That's it for me this week. Thanks again to our sponsors, and a special thanks to those of you who read and subscribe to the Kitsap Sun. We couldn't do this without you. See you next week. We'll be right back.